Hello, hello, you cool cats and kittens. My name is Janice Hazuka, and welcome to my Instagram story takeover. Today we are in Shenzhen, China, and I'm going to take you out and about into the world and experience a day in my crazy little life. All right, real quick fun facts about me so we can just like check all those boxes. I am 26 years old. I am from America. I am from Minnesota, Cassin, Minnesota, to be so exact, very loud and proud to my 507 peeps at home. I have a bachelor's degree in education, and I am TEFL certified. All right, I'm not gonna lie. I'm actually super, super excited to be taking over this story today. When I was home in the States and I was preparing for this big journey, I was looking through people's takeovers and just like seeing where they were in the world and like what they were doing in their everyday lives, because I wanted to know what it was like to like pick up and start over and start anew. So I'm very excited to take you out into my world today. Because the world is a little crazy, I will break down kind of what we're going to be doing. Okay, I think this is a very key time to kind of break down the education system that is occurring in China and probably all over the world right now. So all schooling for kids are being done online. We have adjusted to it. Classes happen as they can, and we are just trying to make the most of it until we can get back into the school, into a classroom with our kiddos. Today, I do not have any online classes, but I will be going into my center, my training center, and doing some work. We are preparing the classrooms and the school, so when that day does come, we are ready to go and we are ready to get back to teaching, doing what we love. All right, so as mentioned, we will be going into the center today. I'll be taking you on a tour of my undeserving apartment complex and rooftop and my quaint little studio apartment. I will be introducing you to some great people here in China and just spreading the word, giving good advice, answering questions, eating local cuisine, hitting the streets, and just literally exploring. That's all we do all the time. We just hit the streets and see what happens. All right, my little social fam. So before I kind of tune out for a little bit and go into the center, get my stuff done, I'm going to leave a little blurb here or wherever I can kind of drop this to answer questions, give advice, literally ask me anything. There'll be so much that'll be exposed to you later on in the day, but let's answer them now and then we'll figure it all out. But before I do, I want to also give you guys a little teaser. This is my playground. I literally have way too much fun. I really need to tone it down sometimes, but never. We're in China. We are abroad, baby. All right, guys. I'm seeing some amazing questions rolling in, and I'm going to make sure I answer every single one of them in between all my meetings today. Also, side note, China is 1 million degrees. We are literally drenched in sweat, so quick outfit change. Real, real swift. I wanna be on All right, everybody. So we have arrived at my center outside of my school, and everybody has been asking the big looming question, where do you work? What school are you at? Well, let's just take a second. Let's take a peek. Oh, hey there. How you doing? All right. So because Disney English is a corporate-wide name, I can actually take you guys into the center, and I will be in there from about 11 to 2. But I will see you guys on the other side, and I have many questions to answer in the meantime. So I will see you guys in a little bit. Are your hands shaking? Are your fists breaking? Are you climbing over walls? Are the times changing? Is the noise fading? 'Cause I wanna get it all. All right, family, welcome back. And now we do lunch in the park in literally just a little grassy, shaded, flowery, beautiful area right across from our center. So this is what we got. We got cucumber, lotus roots, potatoes, like peppers. And on such a hot day, you literally just need to eat veggies and be cool, because we eat noodles every day all the time, but this is where it's at. This is that good, good. All right, so a little bit about what I do here. I am a foreign language trainer, meaning I work at a training center. It's not a school. Kids go to schools during the day, and then they will typically come to our school in the evening for maybe like an hour or two at a time. Every class is about 2 hours. Each class has at maximum 15 kids, so it's kind of a nice collective group, but it can get a little crazy sometimes. I work 5 days out of the week, and I work potentially from hours 2:30 till 8 on Monday, Thursday, Friday, and then I will work from 8 to 6 on Saturday and 8 to 8 on Sunday. So it is taxing. It is a lot of time and effort put in, but there's a lot of time for prep for lesson planning, which I'm not gonna lie, a lot of people have asked this question. I was not very good at lesson planning when I came here to begin with, straight up. But it's all just about trial and error and practice and just throwing in your creativity and your willingness to try something even if it fails. And that's pretty much like the biggest beautiful concept to learn about life. All right, fam, so lunch has commenced and now we make the trek back home. But let's just take a little gander at what we're working with here for. This is basically like the front yard of my school. My school is right there. And now we make our way into one of my favorite places in Shenzhen. And I get to walk this route every single day. So I think you guys are going to dig it. It's pretty dope. Okay. Oh, sunshine. That is shining bright. So it's a beautiful Sunday afternoon, and it's like perfectly spent here in Coastal City. It is always popping. There are kids and families and people just like hang out at Starbucks all day long. It is nuts. Starbucks is like a nightclub here. I swear to God, at 11 o'clock on like a Saturday night, you can barely get a table. But that's another story. But no, this place is just like so open. There's games and malls and bars and restaurants and so many things. And this beautiful little, I don't even know what this thing is. It's just like a beautiful sculpture of sorts. And during the day, it just provides all this like cool graphics, like with like the shades coming through. But at night, you flip the switch and.
Look, I just flipped the switch. Flip, flip. I don't know nobody else that's doing this. Bodies start to drop, ayy. Hit the floor. Now they wanna know me since I hit the top, ayy. This a rolling, not a stop. Watch shit, don't ever stop. This the flow that got the block hot. Shit got super hot, ayy. Give me my respect. Give me my respect. I just took it left like I'm ambidextrous.
Okay, so we are literally home, third outfit of the day, everything is drenched in sweat, but now, where the hell did the rain come from? Alright guys, I know it's a big moment, it's what everybody kind of anticipates, looking at where you would be living if you were to come to China, so let's go and check out my little oasis. Let's go. All right, everybody honestly in China just like leaves their door open. Everybody loves everybody. But so this is my little craft project of an apartment. And honestly, I can do one spin because it's not that big, but it really does have everything that I would possibly need. All right, so this is kitchen area and literally boom, boom. You get one nice countertop, and you just kind of have to like make the most out of your space in China. That's what like everybody needs to do. You don't get a stove, but you get a hot plate here. And be warned, these things are scorchers. They can boil water in like 2 seconds, so watch your fingies. All right, you get a washer. You probably will never find a dryer in an apartment in China. Everybody's literally hanging their clothes outside of windows. Like, how does that not fall off 50 stories up? I don't get it. Okay, I'm not sure if there's any of you else out there, but I'm a caffeine addict. Like, I drink maybe like 12 cups of coffee a day. So coming to China, I realized they're only gonna have like teas and hot water. So I smuggled in so much coffee, y'all. Like, there was one thing that I needed more of and that I didn't bring enough, it's gonna be coffee, because when this runs out, RIP. All right, on to the rest. So I actually built this table at the beginning of the whole quarantine shutdown when we were stuck at home in the house bored. I just needed more counter space, so you kind of make do. This one came with the apartment. Closet just full of goodies, and it can never be full enough, especially in China. Ooh, best purchase ever. Literally, a full-length mirror on Taobao probably cost 180 kwai, including delivery, but worth it. Okay, on to the climactic event, the most important feature of the room. It cost me $5 on Taobao, and it's the best purchase of my life. If you don't have a tinsel wall, what the heck are you doing? All right, so my apartment building, it is a huge hub for foreigners. Actually, the entire neighborhood that we live in is a huge hub for foreigners. There's literally people from all different parts of the world, which is really cool. But this up top here is our living area together. So let's go check it out. We are literally too lucky. We have pool table. Over here we have this whole big projector area. And just like hanging out with all the homies. Hi, lovelies. Alright, and there's lots of like workspaces, and we have literally an entire gym at our disposal. This like adorable little artsy bar area is for when they do community events, so it's just really cool. And then you come into this big open workspace. It is so decorated so splendidly. Yeah, everybody's working so hard, and I'm playing so hard. And just as the day began, we are back where we belong.
A little bit of Slurpee.
Just for the walk. Where's my straw? Decided in this husky snuggle puddle and corgi snuggle puddle that I'm going to take this dog with me, and I'm going to name it Johnny because I'm not going to call myself.
Hi, Johnny. Hi, snuggle puddle. Oh, I love you. Oh, somebody's getting jelly.
Hello, hello, loves. Welcome back. We are almost commencing and concluding this whole beautiful Instagram takeover. I had a blast. I hope you guys had fun, and I fully intend on getting back to every single question in the book. Please feel free to follow me and get in contact with me prior to this takeover. But I also know that I'm not the only person with the advice and the insight on this end of the line, so I brought in a couple of my friends, if that's okay. So please stay tuned. They have some great words to share just for you. I literally told them, it's all for you guys. All right, J-babes, yeah. If you could give one piece of advice, what would it be?
Pack your suitcase, come over immediately. But my advice would be to get really good with charades and facial expressions, just in case your Google Translate fails to work and there's something lost in translation. Like, use this. It works every time.
All right. The one thing I want to say to everyone and anyone watching this is, get out your comfort zone. Do something that matters for you today. Your job will only pay your bills. Your day-to-day life is what matters. Enjoy the hustle.
My advice would be to be patient. Be patient with the kids, be patient with yourself and your own abilities. Be patient with the parents of the children, be patient with your coworkers, be patient with living abroad, just be patient in general. It will come with time.
My advice is that you should have zero expectations coming in. You should just clear your mind of any preconceived notions you have about where you're going and just be prepared to be completely surprised and bewildered every day.
I would say embrace the fear, because if it doesn't scare you, it's not big enough.
Take this time to learn something new and try to help people around you.
Beautiful, thank you.
And eat healthy and can drink some alcohol to relax yourself.
You tell the world.
Check your alcohol tolerance.
Want some adventure? Come here, you'll find out.
Alright, lovelies, it's about 6:30 in the morning in China here, and that is just the way that we do things, but I am going to turn in. Thank you so much for hanging with me for the day, and I can't wait if I ever get a chance to show you around my world. Sending love, I hope everyone in the world is safe, healthy, happy, and enjoying every single moment they got. Good night.